Welcome to episode 191 of Clarity Compressed. I'm Paul J. Daly. I'll be your host. And today we're going to talk about the difference between being certain and being ready.
Let the good times roll.
This is Clarity Compressed.
Okay, so last night it was like 8:30 or so, and I've been wrestling over this question because I feel like the world is tipping on the sideways, and I've had a lot of great conversations over the last week with my friend Darren Doan and business partner Kyle Mountseer, and we were talking about the concept and the idea that the whole world as we know it is sideways, and it's flipping, and everything is falling, and the people that are hanging on, hoping that it goes back to level, are going to be the ones that lose because it's never going back to the way it was. And the people that are holding on saying, if we can just hang on, we'll get back to where we were. And this is in life, it's in business, and in all of these areas. And the reality is, it's never going back. I think we've gone far enough. And I'm telling you right now, it's never, ever, ever going back. And so that means in this scenario where it is flipping, those who understand that it's flipping realize that there's a disproportionate opportunity to get ahead and to make change and progress while it's flipping. That can be used in two ways. It can be used in a really good way where you can find more opportunity for your family, opportunity for your career and your business. You can make content, you can leverage social media and attention and jump way far ahead because all the old rules don't apply. That's the good way. The bad way is, there's another good way actually. Another good way is you can realize what really matters in this world and what really matters in life. And you can start to discount all the things that you counted on that were stable and steady and given. And you can lean less on those things and lean into more things like relationship and raising your children and being engaged. And so those are all the good ways that it can change when things are like this and you can leverage that. Let's talk about the bad things. The bad ways it's leveraged is by, I think, honestly, government and organizations that would want to use this and leverage it as the crisis that it is to gain more control and reach and regulation and rules and oppression, all that stuff. So people can not waste a good crisis for the bad reasons or the good reasons. And I'll let you decide which side you think is which. So I've been thinking about all these things to set it up. I was kind of settling down, getting ready to go to bed. I just put little Jade in the bed and winding down. And this question came to mind. Who is more successful? The people who are certain or the people who are ready? And so I posted that as a poll on LinkedIn and just said, who do you think is more successful? And then option A is those who are ready. Option B, those who are certain. And I was like, LinkedIn at nighttime, not much activity. And I just wanted to get it out there. Well, I woke up this morning and there's like over 5,000 views and growing on this one post and people are voting. People are having conversation. And I realized, I think we hit a nerve. So I decided to make this podcast to go a little deeper into that thinking. Right now, as it stands, the split is about 60-40. 60% of people say ready are the people who are ready are going to be the ones that are more successful. 40% of the people say the people who are certain are going to be more successful. But as you start to read through the comments, and as actually I had this discussion with Kyle on our regular podcast, by the way, a little plug, if you want a regular podcast, quick shot of 5 to 15 minutes, Kyle and I do one every morning. If you search The Contagious Five, you'll get to that. And it's just a good shot of energy and good spirited education and insight in the morning. So join that if you can. But we were talking about this a little this morning, and I realized how you define certain and how you define ready have a whole lot to do with your answer to that question. So let me explain my perspective of that question when I asked it. Certain, I define certain as being, having certainty of the outcome. So when I say, well, I'm certain, then I know what the outcome is and I'm going to move forward as if I know what the outcome is. Ready, however, is much more akin to the way a football team is ready to play the opposing team. They've done the training, they've watched the tape, they've had their practices, and like I'm an Eagles fan, so like last week when we got smushed by Dallas or 2 weeks ago, whatever, going into that game, I think the Eagles were ready to play. It's Dallas week. We're pumped up. We're paying attention. We know it's important. But I don't think anybody says, I'm certain we're going to win this game. They're really saying, I'm ready to play this game. And another person I listen to a lot, his name's Jocko Willink. You should listen to him, the Jocko podcast. It's amazing. It's awesome. Jocko, Special Forces, Navy SEAL, talks about battlefield dynamics. And basically the way it plays out is like when you go into a battle, you can have your plans and you can be ready. You can be prepared, physically prepared, mentally prepared, have the equipment you need to do the job. But every war strategist will tell you, you never ever know what the battlefield is going to bring. You never can be certain of what the enemy is going to do. There's too many dynamics. So you can never be certain. In sports, you can never be certain. An Olympian goes up to perform, they can never be certain. They can just know that they are ready. So in that essence is why I say ready is more important, because ready means prepared, means I did the work, means I've done the training, and I've built an elasticity into my mindset saying I've done the work to make sure I'm as nimble as possible, I'm as prepared for as many situations as possible, and I'm ready to take the fight. I think the fact that I have the shirt on today is just ironic. It's my Go Fast, Don't Die shirt. It's a motorcycle brand. I love it. But Go Fast, Don't Die is about being ready. It's not about being certain, right? You're going to hit the road. We think we're so certain every day. We hit the road, whether it's on a motorcycle or in a car or whatever, we're certain we're going to get there. Actually, maybe we shouldn't be so certain. Motorcycle life, right? You can never be certain. You can just be ready. So I think Go Fast, Don't Die is a good reflection of how I feel. But in this business climate, I think being certain, saying like, oh, I know we're going to hit this mark. I know we're going to hit this sales target. I know we're going to build this team. I know we're going to get this many followers or this many people to our event. I think when you say that, you're setting yourself up for a big problem, because when you are certain, what that does is build a stoicism into your thinking. And focus is good, but focus without the acknowledgement that things can and will change, and you have to be ready to pivot and move with those. I think that's a death march for any business that's in business right now, because once you're rigid, you know what that's code for? Out of business! Rigidity is code for out of business in this climate. It's also, you know, I like to go business and family. This also merges into my personal life and my family life. You never know how life's going to go. You don't know if there's going to be a sickness, God forbid. You don't know if all of your plans are going to go the way you think they should. You don't know if the house is going to turn out the way you thought it would. You don't know if your kids are going to follow your advice or take the advice of someone that doesn't have the same intention. We don't know these things. Not to mention, like, however you're raising your children right now, to think you can be certain what world they're going to grow up in is a joke. It's a joke, because you can't be. But what you can do is teach them the principles and the mentalities and the mindset and the kindness and the flexibility and the empathy and the care that makes them ready. So I hope this got you thinking today. I'm ready to go on a bit of a trip. It's going to be Digital Dealer Week coming up next week, or the week when you're seeing this, Tuesday night. Actually, you're going to be seeing this on the day of this big event. We're having a big event Tuesday night in Las Vegas. It's the Evening of Digital Dealer. It's called Here's to the Troublemakers, where we got together a bunch of amazing people, and we're going to have live podcasting and food and drinks and swag and, you know, selfies and step and raise banner, all that. With that, I'm not certain how that evening is going to go, but guess what? I believe we're ready. We did the planning. We invited the people. We have the things going on. Our contingency is going to happen? Yes. Is something going to go wrong? Yes. But what are we going to do with that? Are we ready to bring it together? And whatever happens, just keep that momentum going. Or are we certain it's going to happen? Well, I'm ready for it. I'm not certain. I'll let you know next week how it went. But I hope this gets you thinking a little bit this week. I hope you start thinking, how can I better be ready and not be so certain? Until next week, pursue that clarity. I'll talk to you soon. We can-